This is a beautiful Monday morning, and I decided to purchase a new mech. I've had Mad Dogs in the past, but I'm going to try and play this one the way it came when I purchased it in the store. So I just purchased this guy in the store just a moment ago, and this guy is bone dry basic. It's exactly OEM. Even has those stupid arm pieces that I just can't get my head around. They don't do anything. They don't serve any purpose. So let's take a look at this thing. Huh, Streaks and Artemis. Yeah, that's going away. I'm going to keep the omnipods, but I'm definitely not keeping the weapons. I'm not crazy. Doop de doop de doop. I usually keep just a little bit more in the center torso. And let's just max everything out and see what this thing looks like. I purchased this particular one for a reason. And it comes down to the quirks. And let me show you. So this is the Mad Dog B. Is in Bravo. It's, I believe that's what it is. Yeah, the B. There's nothing special about it. It's not a special variant, not anything else. And it comes with XP bonus, 3.5. All right, I'll take it. So that helps skill it out a little bit faster. Here's where it really comes into play. The firepower. Energy heat, -5. Missile heat, -5. Missile cooldown, -10. Missile velocity, +10. Then it's got the usual armor quirks and so on and so forth. And so what I can do with this, if I have any... Oh, I do have some XP around. So we got 16. And what can we do to make this thing fun? I mean, there's nothing going on here. Nothing's even ever been skilled. You can see everything's got the little yellow thingies or whatever around them. So the first thing is to get an extra consumable slot and then start building up the armor so I can survive a little bit better. And what is this going to do for me? There we go. That's about it. So I'm going to take two of these out and put them into ammo, because that's where this is about. This is going to be an LRM boat. Whoops. Other direction. So, ER large lasers? No. We're going to strip all that crap off. Strip. And LRM-15s. Actually, because it's only got three missile points, I'm going to go with three of these. Yeah, there we go. So now I've got 10 tons to play with. Get rid of these stupid arm things. I'm sure they serve a purpose, but honestly, I can't figure out what it is. I mean, I still have all the quirks. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to just go with two ER medium lasers. And actually, I think what I'm going to do, so I'm going to make one of these a LRM-15 like I do on my Warhammer 2C. Yeah, there we go. So right now the heat is 1.24, so I don't even have to think about heat right now. I can add one single double heat sink, and that should solve my heat issues. I'm going to put it in the center torso. That way if I lose a torso, it's not a big deal. So we're at 129, so I got all the heat that I want, so let's add some ammo. And I'm going to put the rest down on the legs because this is a case-protected mech, as in it's a clan mech. And so basically the way it works with clan mechs, in case you guys don't know, I'm sure you all of you do, is the ammo is going to get used first from the center torso if it's there, and then it's going to go from the side torsos, and then it'll go from all the other places next. That's the way it was explained to me. I believe Bardo explained that about 6 years ago. And love his matches. I just wish he was doing this game and not Mechwarrior 5, because I think Mechwarrior 5 is just a updated version of Command & Conquer. Maybe it's gotten better, I don't know, but a lot of people say that they hate it. So, and I don't usually go with the masses, but in this one I'm going to. So we got two LRM-20s, an LRM-15, and then four ER medium lasers. Now, I have the option to go with a fifth one and lose a ton of ammo, but then it changes my heat quirk. And a damage firepower of 79 is usually right in line with what I do with most of my LRM boats. Right around someplace between 75 and 84 is what I typically do. Some of them are higher because, you know, obviously they have more damage that they can do, like the Nova Cast and stuff. But I want to get in, hit it, and quit it. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to add a cool shot and a UAV, because it's always fun. And I spent $805,000, which I can afford. So skills are done. So weapon groups, left and right. And, you know, if I had a 141 on the heat scale, I could just alpha strike the LRMs, but I'm not going to. And so let's see what we can do with this. What does this look like? Red, black, and white. Yeah, that works. Maybe change the paint scheme around just a little bit. Go with white, black, and red. Ironically, it looks about the same. How about black, red, ooh, black, white, and red? Actually, I like that quite a bit better. Oh, that was easy. Cockpit items. If I was a sniper, I wouldn't have any kind of, what am I thinking of? Any kind of war horn, because putting a war horn on a sniper is like, you know, putting up an invitation sign saying, here, kill me. So we got some XP to help skill this thing out. And I should have another one back in here somewhere. Oh, yes, I do. XP. And then we'll go with a mounted war horn. See if there's the one I really like. I like the one where it goes, oh, yeah, that one. That one's my favorite. Meep, meep, not a big fan. That plays so long. I've got like 7 or 8 of those. I'm using a few of them right now. It's not Christmas time. The hot rod one's pretty good though. You want to hear it? Here it is. And so I'm going to start taking this into matches now and see how it goes. Everybody have a great day. In Override, we trust. Command to all warriors on the surface. Affirmative. Task. Wipe away all hostile. Show no mercy. So this is my first match in my new Mad Dog B, and I've only got 16 skills, which I applied some UAV feature with, along with, you know, an extra skill or whatever, you know, consumable. Yeah, that's what they're called. So an extra consumable and a little bit of armor and additional missiles. So 2070 is plenty of ammo for two LRM-20s and one LRM-15. And now I just gotta set things up a little bit better. You have eyes on the back of your mech. I'm gonna see if I can't alpha strike this. Whoa, what happened there? Hey, is that pink smoke dangerous?
New target acquired. New target acquired. New target acquired.
They're aggressive on the hump upstairs. Damage.
New target acquired. New target acquired. New target acquired.
Enemy UAV, Charlie 3. Copy. Here, where I have some friends.
Safety Delta.
Target destroyed.
And if I can just survive this match, I have a decent chance of getting some good points. I definitely need more armor. The only complaint I have about the Mad Dog, other than the defensive lasers, whether they're lasers or ballistics, are so low in the arms, is that the armor is really squishy. So you can barely get them on target. Atlas, Charlie 3. Low. To the windows. To the walls. Bravo's legged.
Critical damage. Left torso critical damage. Target destroyed.
Amazing, I survived.
Good match, fellas.
Yes, indeed. Let's see how I did. Not incredible. First match, 10 kill assists, no killing blows, 292 damage, 458 taken. One toe stepped on, two saver kills. That's pretty much it. I'm pretty sure my team carried me on this one. Yeah, 1122 damage. I'm in a night star. Yeah, 586, fives, sevens, five, six. Yeah, my team carried me. But it was a good chance to get into a match.